Hello everyone, I'm Snowy, and yes, I am a human, I am not a fox. And this is the first time I show my face in a video inside the furry fandom. And if you guys were wondering how I look, this is how I look. This is how a Puerto Rican fox looks. And a lot of people have been asking for dancing tutorials, tutting tutorials, how to do this and doing that. I'll show you guys a bit of my tutting, some tutting tutorials, and there's a lot of tutorials online. So if I can explain you what it is, you can always search YouTube if you want. And, you know, the first thing I want you guys to know is that I'm going to show you guys, you know, tips, stretches, how to start and stuff like that. And you know, it's very important to stretch and stuff like that, and oh god. Whoa. Oh well, I'll just do the tutorial for you guys like this. Anyway. Tutting is not, you know, something mainstream. It needs a lot of practice. And I'm not trying to scare you guys with all this, but it's not something you do overnight. For me, dancing, I'm a year and a half by now, and you know, I'm still not even close to a really high skill level compared to Apollo, Doryu, Atsu. They have around 5 years, if I'm not mistaken. Sorry if I messed the years up, guys. But yeah. I'm just going to give you guys some tips on how to stretch and some basic moves. If I can't help you, you guys always have YouTube. You just type in, you know, tutting tutorials, and there'll be thousands of them, so yeah. Anyway, the best thing to do is go into a wall. Let's say this is the wall. You want to have your paw or your hand. Either way, you want to put it there and start stretching it. Don't strain it, just stretch it. Just do it for like a minute or two if you're pretty new to it. Have it as, you know, straight as possible. Same thing to the other one. But if you want, you just do like in a prayer position and start stretching the both at the same time. Okay, I'll give you guys a basic one. You know, if it's too hard, I'm sorry, but it's what I consider basic. But this is how you do it. Start in a prayer position. You want to go up, palm touching your tip of the fingers. Your arm goes straight. Then the arm goes down 90 degrees, go out. As you can see, it resembles a box. And when I see tutting, I see it more as in a geometry, you know, math, angles, and stuff like that. You can see right here, I'm doing a 90 degree or somewhat of a 90 degree. And it doesn't have to be complicated. You don't have to be doing 40, 50 degree tuts and stuff like that. You can have, you know, 290 degrees and you start going like this. You can start. You see? I'm constantly in the same angle. It can go like this. You see? It's all in 90 degree. I'm not changing it one bit. So if you guys want to start like this, 90 degrees. Okay, continuing. You got a box here. Okay? You want to transfer it towards your other arm. Like this. I'll do it slow for you guys. You can see I'm slowly transferring it. And as well, you're seeing it's all in 90 degrees. My left arm, is in 90 degrees. My right arm is in 90 degrees. So it's making a box. 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 Then you can add pivot to it with your left arm or right arm, depending on which arm you are. You start going forwards. Then do the same. Transport to your other arm and pivot back. And slowly start to practice this. And you can see, as soon as you start mastering it, it starts to become second nature. You can go faster, faster, faster. So another tip for you guys that are already starting to tut, or you know, want to go on a dance competition and start tutting. Your head movement. I see a lot of people doing tutting and really good ones, but they don't have any emotions or, you know, head movements or anything. They're just statues going like dip, 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 dip. And people don't want to see that. They want to be entertained. And, you know, start going like following your tuts or grabbing your muzzle. Or like wham, 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 wham. Start being creative. Do muzzle tuts. Like this. You know, just be creative. That's another thing about tutting. Always be creative. Don't do the same thing. Yeah, at first you're going to repeat your moves over and over and over. But as soon as you start getting better and seeing other people's tutting, you're going to eventually learn their moves and start adapting your style to it. And remember, don't copy people. Yes, you can take some of the moves. For example, a well-known tutter has done this, which is both thumbs out, right thumb goes down, goes in, and then goes up, left arm goes out, right arm goes down, left arm goes in, and then out. I'll do it fast for you guys. It's kind of hard in first. I'll do it again if you guys didn't see that. Okay. And yeah, that's pretty cool, but it's not mine. I didn't find it. It was somebody else's, but I'm not saying it's mine. You know, I'm just using it. Yeah, but you know, it's all about creativity. Start mixing your tuts. You see? Start mixing tuts. Don't start doing the same box, 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 box. I'll do a small demonstration soon, but before I do, there's two other boxes that are kind of tricky, if you guys want to know. Here's one of them. Okay? You guys are like this. And you go 90 degrees on both, like this. Rectangle. You can go like this. 90 degrees with zero. Or you can just transfer it. You see? Slowly. Slowly. Another type is a bit more difficult and really, really need to have your hands very straight. What you need is one in the bottom, either hand, and then the other has to connect to the other from the top. You see? Here's the top, here's the bottom, and there you go. You have a box. Sorry if it looks a bit weird because I'm in suit and it's kind of hard. But yeah, you can go here, you can get out of it, like this, do another boxes, and, you know, it's just creativity, and just play around with it. And those are the ones I right now know of. The rest are like this, one pi 90 degree, and the other one the opposite 90 degree. Instead of like this, the opposite. See? Forwards, in. It's very basic. But when you start going like this and start combining stuff, it really starts to show how much you've learned and cr the creativity and imagination you're trying to get out of everything. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed a little bit of my tips. And if you guys want more or anything, just comment down or anything. If not, just give me huggles. Just give me huggles if you didn't like it. It makes me feel better. Anyway, I'll just leave a demonstration after this, okay? Bye, everyone. Mwah.